Welcome to the session of Master's Talk, and this Master's Talk is related to your DI and LR section. DI and LR section, one of the important category of DI caselet is that is based on the type 1. Type 1 or T1, you can say based on the tables, graphs, diagrams and plots. Then to understand or to make the DI caselet based on the business or based on the business output, one of the important term during the you can say period of the time, you have to calculate about your growth. Any of the business if you are setting, then growth or growth rate is one of the buzzword you have to just go through financially or calculation wise. Without that, you will not able to gauge your performance, or you will not able to understand which direction your company is moving. To understand your direction of company, or which direction you are going in, correct direction or wrong direction, you are making the money or you're losing the money, one of the indicator is growth or growth rate. How to measure the growth rate? Growth rate we are measuring in three different way. One is called AAGR, annual average growth rate. Another is simple annual growth rate, SAGR. Both are mathematically same, but terminology wise, or you can say different way can be asked, but mathematically it is same, either annual average or simple average. And next is CAGR, compound annual growth rate. That actually it is called growth rate, or you can say return rate. If you are putting money for share investment, then what is your return rate? That is CAGR. That is your CAGR. Based on the CAGR, you will get the return. Then without delay, we just will try to understand what is AAGR, what is SAGR, and what is CAGR. Of course, it is related to most of the time, it is related to your T1 type of DI caselet. That is based on the tables, graphs, and plots. To measure the growth over a period of time, very particular to measure the growth over a period of time for any of the product, economy, shares, etc. The three terminologies are used. Mainly it is used for type 1 DI caselet, that is based on the tables and graphs. Three terminology: AAGR, SAGR, and CAGR. Mathematically, AAGR and SAGR are same and depends on the concept of annual average or simple average. Annual average or simple average, both are same. And next is your compound annual growth rate, that is based on your geometric average. I think both you are able to correlate. Means you can say simple annual growth rate or average annual growth rate will depends on your arithmetic mean, and CAGR will depends on your geometric mean. You are very smart, no need to explain that much. Now just will look, this is very simple data. It is given for two products, product P1 and product P2. Over the period of time from 2001 to 2007, it is given the sum output, either in terms of number of unit or maybe their sales. Here it is given sales. No need to think from your side. It is given in data. It is sales. Sales is given this side, and this side it is given number of years. Then this is sales. Maybe in the any of the point, maybe sales as per volume, or maybe it is given as per value. That is also given. Sales in lakh means sales as per value. Means P1, through P1 product in 2001, 62 lakhs sales was there, and 2001 same product P2 was making 84 lakhs. Now from 2001 to 2007, this is keep on changing, 62 to 71, 83, 76, 87, 92, and finally it is 89. And product P2 is 84, 96, 94, 92, 108, 115 and 123. Few of the years, consecutive years, either sales are increasing or maybe decreasing, but overall during the period of 2001 to 2007, both are increasing trend. Either it is P1 or P2, both are having the increasing trend. P1 is changing from 62 to 89, this is increasing, and P2 is changing from 84 to 123, that is also increasing. Then based on this data, we will able to compare which growth rate is more for P1 or P2 over the very particular period of time. Maybe question will not ask only based on the 2001 to 2007. Maybe they will ask based on these 2-3 years, maybe 2002 to 2004 or 2003 to 2006. Like that data question may be asked, and comparison will be there based on the CAGR of two different type of products. Then sales, it is given in lakhs. To find the SAGR, AAGR and CAGR, one of the best tool for Vedic math, that is called FOM, factor multiplication. Factor multiplication is nothing, it is final by initial. That is only called factor multiplication. Final by initial means what is final value divided by initial value. Whatever you are getting the fractional value, just subtract -1, it will give the percentage increase. If it is less than 1, then just subtract 1, it will give the percentage decrease. That is just different definition of percentage increase or percentage decrease. But based on the terms of FOM, we will able to find SAGR, AAGR and CAGR in very comfortable way. Data can be represented or provided in various types of tables and graphs. It is one of the important data to measure growth trajectory or comparison between two products or growth rate of different zones or area. Data can be given in different way. Or growth rate, one, it is not necessary only it will be measured in terms of sales. It may be measured in terms of GDP. It may be measured in terms of zonal performance, or it may be measured in the terms of different product development or growth of different product, or comparison between two product, or maybe comparison between two different companies. Any of the data can be measured because it is all relative data. Whatever we are going to measure with respect to AAGR, SAGR and CAGR, that is respective, you can say relative data with respect to one year to another year. It is not absolute data, it is relative data. Means 2007, if you want to find the CAGR, then must be given with respect to which year. If you are not fixing your base, you are not able to find the CAGR, AAGR or SAGR. Means simple way, generally hum log bhi bolte hain, agar hume growth ko measure karna hai, then time frame we should know. Means this is a relative data. Maybe CAGR for a long period of time for any product output or any company may be less, but maybe short span of time, maybe 2 or 3 years, it may be very high. That will show the interest of investor, that will show the share value, that will show the company profile in next 5 to 10 years, or you can say forecasting. This is one of the important part of the business, forecasting of the product. That will depends on your that growth trajectory, and that growth trajectory mainly will be gauged based on your CAGR. That much important. I have given that much a story how much important CAGR is there. Once you will become a manager after completion of your MBA degree, CAGR always you have to encounter. It will always tell in different way. It is growth rate, annual return rate. Maybe name will be different, but mathematically it will be measured CAGR. But that time no need to measure this type of formula manually, because your level will be little higher. Once you are going to the C band officer, then your level will be higher. You are not bothered about how to measure the percentage and this all, because your responsibility will be something different. Then that time you will use just a tool, how to measure the CAGR, how to compare the CAGR. Maybe 100 of the company, whatever your competitors are there, you will be able to measure the CAGR of 100 company during the time of 2 or 3 years, and you will be able to take that decision, or you can say decision. This is one of the important work of manager. Decision science will be based on the data, and data can be analyzed. One of the important factor that is called CAGR. That much importance I have told already. Enough. Now just will come to the point, how to compute the AAGR of product P1 between 2001 to 2004. Just will look the data, whatever given. In 2001, it is given 62, and 2004, it is given 76. Means we have to play between 62 and 76. That much only. Then AAGR or SAGR, you can say both will be same mathematically. Factor multiplication minus 1 into 1 by n minus 1 into 100%. That is your AAGR or SAGR. Then factor of multiplication, you know already, final by initial means 76 by 62 minus 1 into 1 by 3. What is 1 by 3? This is just to take 2001 to 2004. Don't count 2001, 2, 3, 4, 4 years. No. This is a small silly mistake. This is the silly mistake we should not do. 4 is the value of n year, means total number of years we have considered 4. 2001, 2, 3, 4. But interval between these 4 years will be how many? N minus 1, due to we have taken 3. 2001 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4. Growth rate will be in between years. Growth rate will be not at the where exactly year is changing. No, growth rate will be there the when 365 days will be gone between 2001 to 2002. Then here, these small thing will be little careful, because once you will not careful, then in place of 3, if you are putting 4 here, your answer will be totally different. Due to I am giving little stress, because here a small mistake, your answer will be totally different. If 100 you are dividing by 3, it will become 33.3%. If 100 you are dividing by 4, it will become 25%. It is huge difference. In place of 100, just suppose if you are dividing 300 by 300 by 3, it will come 100%. 300 by 4, it will 75%. 75 and 100, huge difference. Then no scope. Don't give any air bubbles also between you and your thinking process to make the mistake. Then here FOM minus 1 into 1 by n minus 1 into 100%. 76 by 62 minus 1 into 1 by 3 into 100%. 1.23 minus 1 into 1 by 3. Okay, easy. We are all expert of now this basic calculation, or maybe you can say comparison of data, or we can say Vedic math. Now just will come CAGR or annual growth. Sometimes it is called annual growth, or sometimes it is annual, you can say return rate. CAGR, how to compute, how to calculate? Factor multiplication to the power 1 by n minus 1. That was in that AGR or SAGR, it was a multiplicative. Now it has become in the form of exponent in power. Then factor multiplication to the power n 1 by n minus 1 minus 1 total, and into 100%, that will give you the CAGR. Then 1.23, we are considering the same data, product P1 from 2001 to 2004. Then 1.23 to the power 1 by 3 minus 1 into 100%. Now one of the question, how to compute this one? If it is 1 by 3, then we can make little guess also. But just suppose in place of 1 by 3, if you are facing 2.26 to the power 1 by 7, how to compute this higher power calculation? This is another technique. Just will go in reverse way. Just will go in reverse way. We will take 2 points for consideration, and between that only our answer will fall down. Like 1.23 to the power 1 by 3, just will take it is x. Just to apply the exponent rule, x will come x to the power q equal to 1.23. What we will take? Either we can solve based on the algebra. It will take a lot of time, and maybe you will not arrive at exact solution. If you are consuming the time and still you are not arriving at the exact solution, then why to use? Will not use. If you are consuming the time, you should get the exact solution, exact data, exact answer. If consuming the time also you are not getting exact answer, then we should not adopt that technique. Then here just will take the assumption of two end. Like first we'll take 5% growth rate during these 3 years, then 1.05. Then here first we'll assume x equal to 1.05 for our first assumption. Then 1.05 to the power q means 3 times you have to multiply 1.05, it will become 1.15. Approximately, just we know how to make the square of the number based on that technique. You can apply 1.05 square, it will come 1.1025. No need to worry. Exact number also we will tell within a fraction of second. 1.06 square, it will become 112, and 6 square, it will become 36. 116 36. Then here 1.05 square, it will become 11025, but that much number after decimal, it is no use. We will take only 1.1, and 1.1 into 1.05, it will become 110% of 105. Correct, 105, and afterwards 10%, it will come 1.15. If you are taking x equal to 1.10 means 1.10, you have to multiply 3 times, it will become 1.2 into 1.1, it will become 1.32. That is 100% sure your desired answer 1.23 will lie between 1.15 to 1.32, means exact answer will be between 1.05 to 1.10. Just will take the approximate answer x equal to 1.07, and just will verify our assumption is correct or not. We have to take 1.06 or we have to take 1.08, that much only can be. Then 1.07, if you multiplying 3 times, it will become 1.14 into 1.07, it will become exactly 1.24, means you can say you are almost right, it will become x equal to 07. Same way, you can just calculate any of the numbers, like if 1.39 to the power 1 by 5, how to calculate? Same way you can calculate. Just assume the data, take the two data at the interval of 0.05 or maybe 0.010, and afterwards you will able to calculate, you will able to arrive what will be the exact solution, lie between any of the interval. Then here x equal to 1.07, then 1.07 minus 1 into 100%, it will become almost 7%. That is called CAGR. CAGR is also called annual return of shares or investment. Various terminologies are there, CAGR, but CAGR is one of the important or key concept that will play either you are investing or you are taking the loan. To calculate your EMI, CAGR will be one of the factor. There it will be different way. That reverse way means how your money is just deteriorating with respect to time, that will be calculated during your EMI. Or if you are putting money for investment, then how your money is appreciating with time, that will decide your annual return of shares or investment, or maybe bond or anything. Then just continue to learn based on the different type of DI case slate, based on the AGR, CAGR and SAGR. And this is one of the important technique. It will be used during your entire T1 type of DI case slate, because many of the case slates are coming that is based on the business or business terminology, where these terminology will be used, or directly they can ask what will be the return rate. if they are investing in share market, if face value is 11 rupees or after 3 years it is increasing by certain percentage or after maybe 5 years it is changed to 93 rupees, then what will be the return date? Then just continue to learn at the rate of paroliko.com or download the mobile app. Thank you.